Okay, to begin, my number three was racial profiling to an African-American female due to a suspicion of stealing. My number four, the crisis happened on April 30th, 2019. The organization apologized in an indirect way and is now closing stores for one day of diverse training. There was no specific person who responded. Instead, it was the Twitter account. The hypothetical date will be March 30th, 2019. Strategies I will use are minimization, corrective action, and mortification. Minimization, I will persuade my audience that the situation wasn't as bad. Corrective action, I will correct the action and avoid the situation from happening again. And mortification, I will send my sincere apology. So now I will begin my speech. Sephora stands with our people, planet, and communities to inspire fearlessness. We seek our strengths for greater good through social impact, sustainability, and diversity and inclusion programs. I, the CEO of Sephora, have been impacted drastically with the situation. And not only I have been impacted, but so has the community of Sephora. So it has came to our attention on June 1st, 2019, that this situation happened on April 30th. So a little background, SZA was shopping and one of our employees suspected her of stealing. So the employer called security and the security came and escorted SZA to the back and asked her if she was stealing. Later, SZA announced on her Twitter about this incident and that's when we became aware. So we at Sephora are committed to creating a culture of belonging as we celebrate the beauty and diversity of our people and our clients. So with that, we would like to send a sincere apology to SZA and our community, and we ask for your forgiveness. It was never our intent for this to happen and wasn't our intent of our employer to have this happen. We have not had an incident since we opened in 1970, and we would like it to stay like that with this. Forbes describes us as bring your beauty products to being diverse and adding many faces. So we would like this to continue and having this as our value. We also have two-way convos with our beauties, so we don't want this to set down our values or think of this any less of our company. So with this, we have opened our eyes and bettering our situation and bettering our company. So we would rewrite our policies, we would send mandatory meetings which would indicate diversity training or any racial bias that our employees have to go through. And we have found, as the Harvard Business Review, that diversity training is effective. So we will be implementing that as soon as possible. And any employees hired on will have to take a diversity training class in order to be hired. And not only that, but we have found our store layout to be a little bit complicated, our situation for our employees to define if somebody is stealing. So we're going to open up our layout and not have all these counters in the middle where they're unable to see our clients. So to conclude, we would like to send our sincere apology once again to SZA and ask for your forgiveness. We never meant for this to happen. All the proposals that we have set today, we are going to be implementing them. And this does not represent our values here at Sephora. This was just a situation that had happened. But we hope to fix the problem fast. And we hope that all of our beauty still stay in our community.